Let's sing Holy, Holy, Holy. This morning I want to read from Ephesians chapter 6. Ephesians 6:10 gives us the armor of God. And I think it's very timely to read this passage. Ephesians 6:10 through 20, I encourage you to read along. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the schemes of the devil. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers over this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand firm. Stand therefore, having fastened on the belt of truth, and having put on the breastplate of righteousness, and as shoes for your feet, having put on the readiness given by the gospel of peace. In all circumstances, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming darts of the evil one. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying at all times in the Spirit, with all prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert with all perseverance, making supplication for all the saints. And also pray for me, that words may be given to me, opening my mouth boldly to proclaim the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains, that I may declare it boldly as I ought to speak. So as that passage encourages us to take up the armor of God, and then it encourages us to pray all kinds of prayers and supplications with all perseverance at all times for all the saints. So that is a lot of prayer. And this morning I want to pray for all kinds of different circumstances and for all kinds of different people. And so I'll kind of give prompts, and then I want you to pray where you are. God, we come before you and thank you that we can come at any point in time, that we can be praying without ceasing, that you hear all of our prayers. Lord, I want to lift up people in different circumstances. I thank you that you care for each and every one of your children. You care for everyone in this world. Let's take a moment and let's pray for someone that you know that's younger than you. It could be a believer or maybe a child that you want to pray for their safety, for their spiritual health. God, we lift up these children, these young people to you. Now take a moment and pray for someone the same age as you. Someone that's a peer. Pray for their spiritual health and for their physical health. God, we lift up these peers to you. And now, if you can think of someone that's older than you, pray for someone older than you, or pray for someone as old as you, and pray for their health, spiritual, physical, emotional health. God, we pray for those older than us, that you will keep them well, that you will keep them spiritually well, too. Now, take a moment and pray for someone who's lost. Pray for someone without the hope of Christ, that he might be revealed to them in this time, and they might find salvation. God, we pray for the lost, that you will draw them to yourself, that you will bring them to repentance and faith for your glory. Pray for someone now that might feel alone. Maybe they're isolated, maybe they're quarantined, maybe they're in a nursing home and they can't see visitors right now. And now pray for parents. Pray for parents that are homeschooling their kids all of a sudden because the schools are closed. Or pray for a parent like my wife is watching the kids at home. I'm still working most days. And there's just no chance to go out. There's no preschool. There's can't go to the park. You can't go to Chick-fil-A and go inside the playplace. So pray for parents. Lord, we pray for parents, and we pray that you will fill them with the fruit of the Spirit as they raise their kids and provide for them everything they need. Lord, all these prayers we lift up in the powerful name of Jesus. Amen. I want to read now a passage from Hebrews that connects to a song that I want to introduce to you. And this passage is Hebrews chapter 6, verse 19. We have this as a sure and steadfast anchor of the soul, a hope that enters into the inner place behind the curtain. A sure and steadfast anchor. So the song I want to introduce to you is called Christ, the Sure and Steady Anchor. And this is by Matt Papa and Matt Boswell. And if this is your first time hearing it, pause, look up the lyrics, and certainly follow along and sing along.
Oh,
God, help us to hold fast. We know that you are keeping us to present us blameless and pure, without stumble, before you at your return. Hold us fast, Lord, and help us to continue to trust in you, our sure and steady anchor.